Well, good morning and welcome to worship this morning on this Trinity Sunday. Did you know that the Trinity Sunday is the only time in our liturgical calendar where we celebrate a doctrine and not a person? But to me, the Trinity is all about relationship, the relationship between the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I think at this time in our COVID-19 quarantine, in a world which is looking at racism, we need to come together to worship, to focus on relationship, on the relationships we share with each other and the relationships we share with others in our community. It's great to have Father Jim today to preach for us, and I look forward to hearing more about the Trinity in due course. It's also great to have Kay and Alan and the crew singing and playing for us today. But let us now come to worship. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. The Lord be with you and also with you. Proclaim the name, the Lord, a God who is merciful and gracious, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love and faithfulness. We now sing our first song, our first hymn, Immortal, Invisible. God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. Jesus said, this is the great and first commandment, and a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. We now move to a time of confession, where we bring our sins, our trespasses before our Lord and God. Compassion and forgiveness belong to the Lord our God, though we have rebelled and wandered far off. Let us then ask for mercy, confessing our sins in penitence and faith. Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as our souls. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in newness of life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins. Strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Our prayer for today. Almighty and everlasting God, you have given to us, your servants, grace by the confession of a true faith to acknowledge the glory of the eternal Trinity and the power of the divine majesty to worship the unity. Keep us steadfast in this faith and evermore defend us from all adversities. For you live and reign one God for ever and ever. Amen.
What are you doing? That's naughty. You're not doing that, are you, Abby? What are you doing, you cheeky boy? What I'm trying to teach them today, boys and girls, is about the Trinity. Yeah. Are you listening? Yeah, you're going to be a good boy. Okay, the Trinity is really hard to understand, okay? But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't have a go at trying to understand it. And the Trinity means three persons in one. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And that's the Godhead. Three in one. One, two, three. Yeah? Let me show you. I'm going to do a little bit of an illustration. Let's see how, if this helps. Ready? So, we've got three candles. One. You're going to count with me? One, two, three. So imagine that this is God, yeah, there in the middle. So what do we know about God? Do you want to tell me? Do you want to whisper? What do you know? Yes, he's our creator, isn't he? He made you and he made me and he made all the boys and girls and all the mummies and daddies and everybody here watching, yeah? Why did he make us? Did he need to? No, he didn't. He was really, really happy in the relationship that he had with the Son and the Holy Spirit. He didn't need us. He wanted us. He made us out of love. And if you can remember anything from today, boys and girls, I want you to remember that you are so special and you are so loved by God. Yeah? Now then, who else have we got? Who's next? So we've got God the Father. Who's next? Yep. God the Son. We see how bright they shine. That flame all by themselves. Yeah. So what do we know about Jesus? You can tell me? You got an idea? Come then, tell me. He's our king, our saviour. Yeah? So even though God, oh, look, you're coming undone. Got to be dressed nice for church, haven't we? Yeah? So Jesus is our king. He's our saviour. So even though God loves us, we went a bit astray, and we still do that today. We forget about God. So Jesus, God sent Jesus to save us, yeah? To show us how to be a better human being, to show us how to love God better, to show us how to love each other. So he's really special too. Who else? Who's the third one? Yep, the Holy Spirit. Whoop, broke the match. Is that funny? Well, this one shined nice and bright as well. Look at that. So what do we know about the Holy Spirit? Whose turn is it? Go on then, what do you know? We've been talking about the Holy Spirit for the last few weeks, haven't we? Don't get too close, Abby. Yes, the Holy Spirit is who Jesus sent for us. Yeah? To be our helper. Yeah? To help us do the right thing, help us to say the right thing. Yeah? And to comfort us when we're sad. We spoke about that before, haven't we? So we have these three separate persons: God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, shining bright. Three different roles. But you know what? They're not separate. They're all together. They have that unity. So watch this. What's going to happen when they're all together? What's going to happen to the flames? Look at that. Bright. It's so much brighter and so much stronger. And that's how they are, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, all the time, always together. That's amazing. Look how high it's going. Maybe you could do that at home with your mum and dad. Yeah? And watch that. It's amazing. Good boy, Zeke. Keep him far away this time, not knocking it over. So out of that three-in-one relationship, like Father Scott mentioned, it's all about love. Yeah? So I reckon if we spend some time with God and we can feel that love from him, yeah, then we can show love to others. So I thought as a good activity today, we could all think of ways of showing love to somebody. Oh, that's beautiful. So I thought what we could do today is, you know my husband, Eric, he works really hard as a police officer. So I thought that when he comes home from work, yeah, he loves cake and coffee. Yeah, do you? Oh, Zeke, what are you doing? Gosh, there we go. That's better. Right, I thought we could make him some cake. What do you think? We could do some baking this afternoon. No, yes, and make him some coffee, some fresh coffee. And we can do that when he gets home from work. Yeah. No, you can't. Well, you could. No. Okay, so maybe you could think of some ideas and you could send in what you've been doing to show some love. Okay, let's pray. Father God, thank you for the Trinity. Thank you that we are invited into your relationship where we can feel loved. Father God, bless all these beautiful children and all these people here today, Lord. Help us to feel that we are special and that you delight in us. In your mighty name, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Have a check out in the tidings. See you next week. Bye. Do you want to blow the candles out? Go. Yay.
We're now singing our gradual hymn or song, I Cannot Tell.
Oh, what a shame. With you. The Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew, chapter 28, beginning at verse 16. Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age." This is the Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Right. We have been living in chaotic times. Our slides have reminded us of the chaos that Australians have had heaped upon them in the last year. Drought, fire, flood, pandemic, unemployment, large protests and riots around the world. Perhaps for many it has seemed like plagues of biblical proportion. Perhaps we wonder, where is God? There has not been time to get over one before the second and the third are on top of us. We haven't had time to get our breath. But God's breath has been there. God, the Trinity's signature, is to bring order out of chaos. The first verses of the Bible tell us that at the beginning, when all was a chaotic, formless void, God's Spirit hovered over the chaos. But then, as the Spirit hovered, God, the Creator, spoke the Word, and light overcame darkness. Order replaced chaos. The story of creation, although we did not read it today, is the Old Testament reading for Trinity Sunday. And in these first verses of the Bible, telling the story of the first day, the beginning of time, God, the Holy Trinity, are at work, Father, Word, and Spirit, replacing chaos with new creation, light, beauty, order. And as then, even now, it is from within chaos that God brings forth new creation, new beginnings, new order, new peace, new life. There has never been a moment that God, Creator, Spirit, Word, have not been immersed in our world. What a powerful way for our Bible to start the story of salvation with the Trinity. Today is Trinity Sunday. On Trinity Sunday, preachers often try to explain the Trinity in their sermons, diagrams, pictures, icons, shamrocks. It goes on, and these explanations are often hard to understand, but are a good cure for insomnia. It's even better on Zoom, as you're all muted and I can't hear any snoring. And it's hard to see if your eyes are opened or closed. And if they are closed, you can say you're deep in prayer. But the Trinity has a message for the world, especially for the world that focuses on differentness. Black or white, Labour or Liberal, Republican or Democrat, male or female, Jew or Greek, slave or free, it's been going on for a long time. People discriminate against others because they are different. In the last week, many people around the world are marching under the banner of Black Lives Matter. It's because for centuries, people with darker skin have been discriminated against terribly, seen as inferior, inhuman, without a soul. The list is endless. and lots of different institutions in society, including the church, are responsible for this terrible discrimination. Black skin is contrasted to white. But for the life of me, I don't know how they fool themselves that different shades of a funny colour of pinky brown is actually white. Slavery was the worst form of injustice. And the so-called civilized world accepted this terrible atrocity as normal. Even the Bible said that slaves should obey their masters. But injustices and inequalities still exist everywhere, and especially in the laws, regulations, and the way people of darker colour are treated differently by legal systems and police forces. Unfortunately, it often takes a cruel happening to galvanise people into action. And of course we know not only Black lives matter, but every life matters. Our society has a long way to go, but every little or big start is a step in the right direction. So differentness has seemed to be a cause for so much trouble in the world. And many people ask, how can one God be three persons? As stated already very beautifully by Lorraine, the simple answer is love. They are different, and yet they are one because they love so completely. We celebrate that they are different. They are Father, Jesus, and Spirit, and they are one. They're not one by being the same. They are one by being different and loving perfectly. They teach us that we are not all united by being the same. We are one through loving as perfectly as we can. Look at a football team. Every member has a different role. But the more they train together, use their skills together, know and support each other both on and off the field, we would say that they are a team with one mind and one heart. They work together as one. The more they use their different skills together, the more each individual works to be part of the team, the more they are united, the more they are one. And I think that most team players would even say that there is a certain type of love that helps these rough, tough Aussies, boys and girls, work as a great team. The secret to God being three and one is love. They love perfectly. Perfect love is always beyond us as humans. But the more we try, the more we give, the more we care, the more we are generous, the more we serve, the more we think of others before ourselves, the more we try to be compassionate as the Father is compassionate, the more we follow Jesus' example of sacrificial service, the more we open ourselves to the Spirit who lives in our hearts and whose power working within us can do far more than we can ever ask or even imagine, then we will continue to grow in love. The more we grow in love, the closer to God we will become. The closer to God we come, the greater our happiness will be, the more fulfilled our lives to be, the more our lives will reflect God's love to others, the more we will grow into the unity that Jesus prayed for in his final prayer. We will still experience fires, drought, floods, viruses, protests, and who knows what else. The world is imperfect and some things will never change. But we know that God can be found in the midst of the chaos. We know that from the beginning of time, God has been bringing order out of chaos. When we experience chaos in our own lives, in our family, in our church, in our society, when the world shakes and nothing is normal, when confusion and chaos reign supreme, then remember the Spirit who hovers over the chaos. Hear the God who speaks the word and celebrate the new creation that is taking place in you, in your family, in your society, and in your world.
Let us now together affirm the faith of the Church. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us now pray for the world and for the Church.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, for you abound in love and mercy for your people. Hear the prayers we bring to you today. Blessed are you, O God, our Creator, for you have given us a universe of beauty and splendour. We pray for the world, at present suffering such an upheaval. We pray that as nations emerge from this time, that opportunities for a more just world and better sharing of resources will not be lost. We pray for justice and reconciliation, especially in our own land. We pray for integrity and wisdom in all who govern and have positions of leadership. Look with compassion on your creation and teach us how to live as one family. Eternal God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Blessed are you, O God, our Redeemer, for your love and forgiveness for your people is steadfast and sure. We pray for the worldwide church. We give thanks that you have given us the Holy Spirit to dwell in your people, no matter what the circumstances, to be our guide and comforter. We thank you for new ways to worship and live as a church family. Be with all in our parish, O God, and renew our spirits. Forgive our times of doubt and teach us to live as redeemed people and members of one body. Eternal God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Blessed are you, O God, our comforter, for you are always with us in times of sorrow and joy. We know at this time there are many who are suffering, feeling lonely, confused, grieving, or sad, those who have lost employment, and those separated from loved ones. We pray for comfort, care, relief, and above all, we pray for hope. Teach us to live as a caring community. Eternal God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Blessed are you, O God, Creator, Redeemer, and Comforter, for you bring your people from death to everlasting life. We pray we will know that reality in our lives. Teach us to follow in obedience and trust as those who have gone before us, that we may dwell in your community of love. Eternal God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers.
Grant that what we have asked
in faith, we may, by your grace, receive.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We now come to the greeting of peace, where we'll be able to greet each other in peace using the gallery view after this slide. So we are the body of Christ. His Spirit is with us. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
You can see Archie.
Peace be with you.
Jim.
Laura.
Pick.
Peace.
Peace. Thank you. Peace with
you,
Jeff.
John.
That candle before Lorraine. Good job.
Now we all shift around.
And Jenny.
We now move to our Thanksgiving prayer. All glory and honor be yours always, Heavenly God. We give you thanks and praise for your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. Through him you have reveal to us your glory in the community of your love, three persons, one God, ever to be worshipped and adored. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. The Saviour Christ has taught us we are now confident to pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We're still yet not able to come together to gather physically for communion. We have an act of spiritual reception that we can pray together. In union, dear Father, with Christian people throughout the world and across the centuries who gathered to make Eucharist, hearing your holy word and receiving the precious body and blood, offer you praise and thanksgiving. Even though I am exiled from tasting the bread of heaven and drinking the cup of life, I pray that you will unite me with all the baptized and with your Son who gave his life for us. Come, Lord Jesus, dwell in me and send your Holy Spirit that I may be filled with your presence. Amen. Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. We now sing our missional song, that one that sends us out in the world in which God loves. give me oil in my lamp. Defend you on every side and guide you in all truth and peace. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.